Hello. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to set up the color visualization graph in NEOS. So what I'm going to need is just the developer tool. I'm going to open a menu and create an empty object, create new empty object. And what I'll start with is a mesh renderer component. So I'm going to attach a new one. Go to rendering, mesh renderer. This will take care of rendering my graph. I also need the mesh component itself, so let's attach that. Let's go to the assets, procedural meshes, and there is image color distribution graph. And the last thing I need is material that will be used to render. So let's go to the assets, materials, and I need a material that supports billboard rendering. Image color distribution graph generates a point mesh, essentially a point cloud. The material that supports this is the unlit material. So now I need to set up the mesh renderer so it actually knows which mesh to render with which material. So I'm going to hover over the image color distribution graph, grab it, and you can see the mesh field, and it is currently null, so I'm going to assign a reference. And now I need to add a material, so let's press add. This will add a new material. You can see you can add several, or you can also destroy. This is for meshes that use multi-materials. And let's do the same. Let's grab the material, and let's drop it over this. And now, just to do a quick test, I need this component to generate some mesh data, and currently there is no texture assigned. I'm going to grab the file explorer. I'm going to open my hard drive, and for example, here is a photo I took, so let's import it. Now that the photo is here, I can assign to the component, so let's drop it over texture, and we can see it already generated some visualization. This actually now helps me to tweak the visualization data. So what I can do, move down over here. And if you see, I'm currently not using billboard geometry. So every single point is essentially one pixel point. So you can see that they are staying the same no matter how close I am to them. And this is not the desired behavior. So I'm going to enable the use billboard geometry. And another thing I'm going to do, you can see it's using vertex colors, which is desired. If I disable it, they will not be colored. But another thing is I want to use per billboard scale, because that is also generated by the mesh generation component, so let's enable this. But the actual size is currently too small, because the default billboard size is 0.05, which is essentially 5 millimeters, but it is multiplied by the base size, which is 1 millimeter, which is resulting in very, very small value. So I'm just going to set these to 1, so the actual size is taken completely from the mesh generation component. So let's type in 1, let's copy it over here, and you can see now they are at better size. So I can look at my visualization, it is looking pretty good. So what you can see, the component is essentially goes through all pixels of the image, and for each pixel it will generate a point. If there are more pixels of the same color, it will accumulate a size. Some of the points are bigger than the others, and you can tweak all of these settings. For example, here is the accumulation size. There's also the limitation on the max size, so the points don't get too big in case there's a lot of same color. So let's, for example, try to increase the accumulate size. We can better visualize the pixels that are repeated. So let's press 1. And then we can see there are some of the points are much more bigger than the others. You can also see each point is arranged in 3D space from the origin. So there is one axis which is corresponding to the red color channel, another which is corresponding to the green, and another to the blue. There's actually another mode. You can see there's currently color space is RGB, but you can also switch it over to the hue saturation and value. So let's do that. And you can see this completely changes the look of the graph. All the colors are still the same. However, now the axes actually represent hue, saturation, and value. So these are two different modes that you can use to visualize the data in the image.